Film Companion gets you your film fix. Hit the bell icon and subscribe to get notified every time we drop a new video.
I remember Ram Gopal Varma. I met him in Hyderabad and he narrated Rangeela to me. I was so happy. That was 1994. I remember going home and telling my sister-in-law that she used to work with me. And so I told her that, my God, somebody actually narrated a subject to me today. You know, like they thought that costumes is that important or I am important to the film. So today's characters are more real. They're a lot more small town. You don't really see a girl anymore who lives abroad and she's a fashionista or any such thing. So characters have to be more and more real is better. Like, you know, she's got up, got up from her sleep, her clothes are no, her hair is not perfectly combed. There's no lash. I miss all that, by the way. My mother says at the age of 6, when I had a tuition class, I don't know why she gave me a tuition, this at the age of 6 also. She said the teacher one day complained to her that he's only commenting on my dresses. And he's saying her shoes are not matching and all of that, you know.
Manish, congratulations on 30 years in Bollywood and welcome to Film Companion. The first time I interviewed you, Manish, was in December 1993 for India Today magazine. It was an article called Scene Stealers. I looked that up and I read it again and I was thinking, my God, and here we are doing things we love. I mean, lots to be grateful for.
Yes, absolutely. And I still remember there was a film called Aflatoon when one song, Urmila had worn 20 saris. And chiffon saris. And those days, if you remember, we used to go to Switzerland and shoot those songs with those chiffon saris. And I remember your last line in that interview, watch the film only for Manish Rotha's chiffon saris, lovely colors, and for nothing else. So I still remember that.
You have no idea, Manish, when films get really bad, then I just focus on the clothes because at least that gives you some joy, right? So yes. You've given me a lot of joy over these many years. Thank you for that as well. Mm-hmm. Manish, I want to ask you, so I'm currently reading a book called The Big Goodbye, and it's about the making of Roman Polanski's classic Chinatown. And it's amazing because Jack Nicholson, who's the hero of the film, is saying about the costume designer, Anthea Silbert, that when he wore her clothes, he needed to act less because the clothes already did some of the work for him. And, you know, as I read that, Manish, I was thinking that does this happen in Hindi cinema, especially in mainstream Hindi cinema? And what is the struggle? I know, of course, in more recent years, we are getting into sort of more realistic textures, more naturalistic sort of atmosphere. But for someone like you, who was one of the first to say, script kya hai, situation kya hai, you know, what has been this challenge of balancing between making an actor look good, which is always a number one priority, and making the costume authentic to the character the actor is playing?
So when I started my career, that time what was happening was that, so there were lovely costume designers like the late Bhanu Attaya and so many other designers before me who did some work. But I think the late 80s saw complete, fall of terms of costume or look or any such thing. Like the film, if you see Raj Kapoor's films or you see Guru Dutt's films, you see all those classic films or you see Devanand Shami Kapoor. Great style, great all of it, if you see the 60s and 70s. But somebody, when I came into films, they were all, it was basically in one scene, an actress has long hair. In the next scene, she has short hair. You know? So how does that happen? I can understand clothes change, how does the haircuts change? So, you know, making, because the brief at that time was, she must look good and the character ends there.
Correct.
But where is she from? Where does she live? Is she educated, not educated? She's rich, poor, or she's sexy, right? So what I started doing was in my own way, I started making characters. This, because I always feel all of us are people wear a certain kind of fit or certain kind of clothes that become us. Like everybody has a particular kind of a narrative and comfort.
Yeah.
So I would make that person, like I'll say, okay, in this film, you'll wear only saris because of this person. Until I met directors like Aditya Chopra, Ram Gopal Varma, Karan Johar, Dharmesh Sachdev, 94, 95, lot of films which changed it. But in fact, when I did a film with Vinod, when I did 1942, a love story, that white outfit. Again, he was a devil who was very like, clear, I want only white, Kuch Na Kaho, that song for Manish Akurala. And so there were very few directors at that time who were very certain and clear about what they want. Otherwise, the brief was all glamour. So I started working, and after that also it continued. I remember after Dil To Pagal Hai, at the brief used to be, if she's modern dresser like Karishma Kapoor, if she's Indian dresser like Madhuri Dixit, chiffon, transparent, kurtas, and you know. So then
that
I would
was
tell
the character.
Actors, these are the characters. So now I would say, okay, in this film, Urmila, you will be wearing these kind of clothes. Karishma, let's do this kind of a storytelling in this. Kajol, let's do this. So that's what I started doing to build a look. Because I introduced the concept of a look.
Right.
Which will stay with you, that person dressed this way. But even if the character is just to look good, it becomes a job of the designer to make you look good and feel good, right? And hide the flaws of any kind of overweight or things like that. You know, everybody has a flaw. Everybody has a minus and a plus point. So the job became that if the brief is, she has to look glamorous, and let me make her look glamorous in the film so that the person is already, okay, I'm looking glamorous. Now I have to concentrate on my dance move, on my scenes and all of that.
Correct. They're not worrying about that.
I feel even, yes. So even in commercial films, where maybe there's not some great performances to do, but even looking good all the time is also a job. And sometimes even more difficult. Because when you're going into real, you're like, okay, I'm not going to do so much makeup. Even if the sari is crumpling, it's fine. You know, it's looking more and more realistic. But when it's, everything has to be proper, from the, you know, your eyelash to the fall of the fabric to the embroidery to make you look slimmer, fitter, all of it. That's a lot of work. Actually, that sometimes is more work for a designer, because it's, the fit has to be correct and, you know, all of it. So I remember even picking up a lot of ready-mades, that whole look of, you know, when I came into films, Western clothes used to be tailored.
Yeah.
And it was Yashji who said, I don't like it. I prefer Western clothes to be picked up and put together. So I would actually pick up clothes, recut them, put zips at the back so that they fit more properly in a film, you know, or put one sleeve over the other, cut, you know, ready-made skirt into a shorter skirt, or, you know, or make a blouse out of a skirt and things like that. So it was styling mixed with costume designing.
But do you remember when you started having conversations about character, when it went past this just make her look good? When did that happen?
I think I remember Ram Gopal Varma, I met him in Hyderabad, and he narrated Rangeela to me. I was so happy. That was 1994. I remember going home and telling my sister-in-law that she used to work with me. And so I told her that, my God, somebody actually narrated a subject to me today. You know, like, they thought that costumes is that important, or I am important to the film.
Yeah.
And then, of course, after that, Aditya Chopra, Othagan Dharmesh Darshan, Karan Johar, they all were directors who would narrate. So that's when 95 is when the time started changing. But yet that was 30% of film directors. But yet the 70% brief was, she has to look good.
Yeah.
You know, that did continue for a long, long time.
Manish, I feel that especially through the films you've done for Dharma and, of course, Yash Raj, you've been a sort of key architect of what constitutes a beautiful woman. You know, the clothes you've created have helped us kind of see this fantastical woman who and see that this is what beauty should be. How do you think the notions of beauty have changed in the last 30 years?
Well, I think today films are very, very categorized. So there's a period film where you can go over the top, or your dialect can be a little more Bollywood and film, you know, film, as they say, film-oriented, dramatic dialogues and all of it. Then comes otherwise all the films have become real characters. Either they are biopics, or then they are girl. So that from Jab We Met, that girl who was in New York, London, changed to a small town girl. So now our main actress is always a small town girl. That look that we started in Jab We Met, where she wears a salwar with a t-shirt, or she wears a kurti with a denim jacket, or a sports zipper jacket. So her day-to-day, you know, clothes became the whole style of the narrative. So today's characters are more real. They're a lot more small town. You don't really see a girl anymore who lives abroad and she's a fashionista or any such thing. So characters have to be more and more real is better. Like, you know, she's got up, from her sleep, her clothes are no, her hair is not perfectly combed, there's no lash. I miss all that, by the way. And so she's, you know, she's a mess. And so, you know, how she would be even if she, you know, so that's become more and more, that's what the look today is. So I also feel the backlash of that is that what name I could make out of costumes, because I was presenting beauty. I was presenting a vision for a lot of the young NRI kids who probably were stuck between their parents, holding to their cultural roots, to the very modern friends that they would have, and introducing that whole top with the sharara, you know, which Kareena wore, bole churiya, to a t-shirt blouse with a sari and all of that. That today is seen a lot more on the red carpet than maybe in films.
Right.
So today, and also the actors of every film has another stylist. And here I was from here to for years, almost 20 years, 20, 25 years nonstop, working on every film of the actor.
Mm.
You know, so that collaboratively made a strong statement, whether for me or for the actor.
Sure.
But today, I think it is more about the look and the feel of the, you know, the role. So I think that that's where it's all changed today.
But you say that you miss it because there was a possibility of sort of creating drama.
That's right. Creating drama and creating a beautiful vision, you know, creating a vision which is probably not all the time possible. But, you know, for me, cinema was always that, not that a chiffon is flying and she's looking stunning or the hero's looking handsome and, you know, all of that, right?
Right.
Just, the more real it is, the more identifiable it is.
Correct.
For me, cinema is yet something where because I feel if you see all the film of the 40s, you see Andaz, which was made in 1947, and you see Nargis's costumes in that film. She's playing a very high society girl, but her costumes are believable and they are glamorous, which is what Rangila was. It was the next-door girl character who's smartly dressed, so it's fashionable as well. And in the songs, it went into a different kind of a dramatic illusions almost, you know.
Yeah.
But you see a lot of the earlier filmmakers, whether it is V. Shantaram, Guru Dutt, Raj Kapoor, Devanand, you know, see all their films. There are Bimal Roy also, who in their genre, they made those clothes, which were, there was something to it. Yeah. I feel that something to it, that kind of zing is what we need to, they'll get back.
Mm. I remember, Manish, there was this great line, and I don't remember exactly what he said, but apparently when Randhir Kapoor saw Mohabbatein, he said, what was the line? He said, ki Shah Rukh Khan ne to sweater pehne.
Yeah.
What did he say? Tell me.
That line, I think he said, ki weather kya tha? Because Shah Rukh Khan is wearing, you know, Amitabh Bachchan is wearing, Amitji is wearing the Sherwani trench coat vibe, while Shah Rukh Khan is wearing shirts with sweaters, while the girls are wearing very small clothes. or Aishwarya has the, you know, the chiffon saris with the strappy blouses. So
he said, yahan ka weather kya tha? That was a great line. But, you know, when I was reading that article that we did back in the day, it was funny because it said that what producers want most is, and their one-line brief was, sasta banao or sexy banao. Right. That was what all producers said to the costume people. Now, what is the brief today? Do you find that more and more directors are coming to you and saying that find absolute authenticity?
I don't do as many films as I used to do before because I am also doing, a lot of my other work, but I think that the people who come to me are expecting a certain kind of glamour.
Right. So you are the man for glamour. You're not called in for the realistic look, quota.
No. I mean, the whole balance of realism and believableness of today mixed with a certain glamour and the experience that I come with.
Yeah.
You know, whether it's costumes are also a lot about the fit, the construction of a garment. It's not just about the look. So, and a lot of times when there's a dance or there's some song sequence where a construction is required, and maybe today's younger stylists can pick up clothes, but not really get into the construction of how would it fit and how would it look, you know, throughout. And if she turned this way, it would look like this on screen. So I think I come from that experience. And I also have the knowledge of what is happening today. So I guess that is the reason even after 30 years, I'm working with Janvi, Kiara, Sara, all. And it's almost like the fourth generation of actresses that I'm working with.
You know, I'm going to get to that. But first I have to ask you, Manish, that to do this, to work with every A-list actress in Bollywood requires, of course, great talent, but it also requires great diplomacy. What would happen, Manish, if there was a disagreement with a director or with the actor, especially with an actor?
That happens many a times. But you know what? I also came from that school where I said, I believe in this. Let me make it for you. If you don't like it, I will change it. I will not charge you extra. It's not that I'm going to charge you. I will overnight change it for you. But let's try this. When you come with that kind of a belief, very seldom is somebody like, okay, don't do it. When you're only saying that I'm ready to work hard and I'll change it for you, let me go for it, let's try something, then I guess a lot of people give in also.
Yeah.
And you know, another thing with me, what is very different here is that I am in love with films, right? And my entire childhood is in a film theater almost, wide-eyed, watching every single
That's
film.
That's your training, actually, since you didn't go to a school.
My mother says at the age of six, when I had a tuition class, I don't know why she gave me a tuition, this at the age of six also. She said the teacher wanted to complain to her that he's only commenting on my dresses. And he's saying her shoes are not matching and all of that, you know.
Oh my God, you must have been the student from hell, Manish.
Bad student. But I know every Rekha Ji's blouse piping to what she wore, where, what is the song that she's done. Whether it's Mumtaz, Rekha Ji, Hema Ji, Zeenat Taman, Shabana, you know, need to sing. All their clothes is something that... So I think films has been such a medium of interest and love and passion that I think that also is something that keeps me going. I'm still, even if you call me at 1 o'clock at night to discuss something, I'll be very excited discussing clothes.
Manish, I was reading an interview you did a couple of months ago and you were talking about how many of the actors of the younger generation somehow can look all the same just because we're seeing too much of them. Because pre-lockdown, there was the, you know, there was the airport look and the gym look and the salon look and then the red carpet look. But the truth is that there are cameras everywhere. Social media is so prevalent. You know, you're a massive Instagram figure. You know, how do actors balance this? Do you think it's important for them to look good all the time?
Well, I don't think so. It's important for them to look good all the time because everybody is already into fitness these days. And, you know, a certain kind of look is what everybody has. I also feel that there has to be a balance. And that's for all of us, right? I've learned that in the lockdown as well.
Yeah.
I think there also has to be balance. Like if I constantly just keep speaking about clothes, even on my Instagram or social media, people say, we know you make clothes. Is there anything more to you? Do you know what I mean? Like, is there any music that you like? Or is there any film that you like? So I think that now with a lot more knowledge, we need to see, if you're out there on social media, then we definitely need to see more moods, more personality as well. Otherwise, just seeing someone's look, I fear that the actor could fade out even faster.
Right.
Because we're seeing so much of the actor that I'm not so sure whether you'll start believing their roles because you've seen them day in, day out, you know. And if you know them, you've seen them just so much that you're not really interested beyond the point.
Yeah.
So my fear of anything that is very familiar can also get a bit boring for you soon. You can get over it. It's like, what is that line familiarity brings?
Breeds contempt.
So I fear that.
Also, it puts a lot of pressure, especially on the women, right? I mean, I remember an interview I did with Pariniti and she was saying that she walked out of her friend's house and, you know, at very late at night and there happened to be some paps there and she was wearing chappals and, you know, those photos then, the chappals were circled and it was, you know, all sorts of things were written. I mean, how do you think, like you said you're working with Kiara and Sara and Janvi, of course, you know, how do women who are so young handle that kind of pressure? Do you see? Are you concerned about that?
I just feel that if they just say, okay, we're not going to really care about what's circled and what's written, and we're going to be you, I think that will never be a phase where people will accept that, you know?
Mm.
And it is for the young girls to do that because they have they're very young. They have all the right to be themselves. If they're dropping into a friend's, you know, house for dinner or something, for a drink or a dinner or whatever, for a party, they don't always have to be fully makeup and there, right? It's not a film premiere. So, but I just hope that everything shouldn't become a red carpet, a friend's house to an airport look, to everything shouldn't seem staged.
What do you think of airport looks, Manish?
I find them ridiculous. I just feel that, what is this? I mean, come on, you're traveling. It doesn't have to be. It's fine. Let people write that you're not so well dressed. That's fine. Right. But you're an actor and you're a great actor. That's what matters ultimately. You know?
Yeah.
Because even well-dressed or being or an opinion on dressing is very subjective. What I might like, you might not.
Sure.
You know? And so I think that otherwise everything seems very staged. It's almost not seeming that, my God, this person to take a flight would have dressed up for 2 hours. It's not required. And I just hope that, I really pray to God that after lockdown, we all come out as different people. And I think we should stop caring for critique also. Because there's always somebody there who's doing that and saying that, oh, that's not right, or that shoe's not right. It's fine. I liked it. I'm going with it.
Right.
Should be the vibe. You know, yeah. I think we all should just be and almost celebrate life, because look what all everybody's gone through, right? You know?
Yeah.
All over the world.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, Manish, I was thinking that there's no other country like India where fashion and film are so joint at the hip. The influence on fashion of film is enormous, and it's been there since the days of Rajesh Khanna and you know what Amit Ji wore in his film. So it's been there forever. I'd once asked the designer Rajesh Pratap, has Bollywood stunted fashion? And he immediately said yes. What is your take as the one person who kind of navigates between both worlds?
I feel if something is strong, it can never be stunted by anything. You know, if your fashion is there, up there, and it has to connect, it will connect. More so today. So let me give you an example. Like earlier, about say a couple of years ago, when a bride came to us for an outfit or a bridegroom, mother spoke, mother-in-law spoke, everybody spoke. But today, like in the last 3 years, when a bride comes or a bridegroom comes, they are so clear of what they want. Nobody speaks. So it's not the bride and bridegroom who've changed. It's the mother and the mother-in-law also have changed. Right. And said, you know what? You do what you have to do. Look at the knowledge the kids have for. They are bright. They know what they want. Right? So I think that, I don't think they say, oh, I saw this film star, but I want the exact same thing. They might like it. They might admire it. But they're very clear on what they want, because they're so influenced by everything that they read and they see.
You started the tradition of the showstopper at fashion shows, right? Because you had so many people who, and it was organic. They came because they were your friends. You made clothes for them, and then they started to walk on the ramp. But and then it became this thing that it became like, who is the showstopper? For every designer, it was like, who is the showstopper? Yeah. You don't think that kind of took away from what are the clothes? Nobody was asking that.
Well, so what is important? Is it important that we want people to ask us what are the clothes, or the clothes to go into the stores and for people to come and want to wear it? Because for me, what I feel very blessed about is that I wake up every morning to do something that I love. And there is somebody there who wants to buy it, wear it, and feel really good. When that person feels really good, I feel good, right? So I've introduced a lot of things which I got a lot of bashing from the fashion industry. But then later on in life, it became a norm. So one was the sequence, the glamour, the bling. Second was the showstopper. Third was the front row. I just feel a film star is somebody who has a recall value, or somebody, and they wear the clothes. But ultimately, it is the garment which will take over. It's not that if a bad garment is given to a film star, people are going to buy it. Don't underestimate the mind and the power of the buyer.
Right.
They are very clear on what they want. I have had some showstoppers where those garments didn't really sell that well, and maybe the other showstoppers were sold better. So ultimately, it all falls down to the work, you know. Like, it's like a film releases and we say, you know, they drained, or this one didn't turn up. That was, it's ultimately the film that will work or not work.
Yeah.
So I feel that's for anything in life. But in my case, truly it was organic, because I was coming from costumes and movies, and I had like when I made Urmila Walk for the first time, as like, we've done Rangila together, that's my first show. It was an emotional thing, you should walk. Or they were people who I was working in the movies so regularly. How can I not call them for my fashion show? Right. Now, if I'm calling them in my fashion show, how can I not dress them up? So it kind of just, you know, flowed in.
Correct. You know, you started your label 15 years ago. And I remember reading somewhere you said that you were actually offered a film at that time. And you said no to the film. You sacrificed the film for the label. Is that still a dream? And do you have any regrets about that decision?
I've always been in love with films, whether I have to produce one or direct one. And I wrote an entire script. And then it was, and then we went down to the label. The label started. I left it at that time. But I'm sure there'll be a time when I'll come back to it. And right now with the digital move where we made couture fashion films, I did a film which Janvi was in it as well for the India Couture Week closing show, and Rastop, one which came out last night where Karthik Aryan was in it. And that was, I'll send you the films, and that was for Lakme Fashion Week opening night. And I can't tell you, I so enjoyed, you know, working with different musicians. So there was Abhi Sampa from London who did the track for the earlier film. And there was Jasleen Aulak from Chandigarh and London. She's done the track for this. Whether it was the visualization, sitting with my teams who worked relentlessly, whether it was discussing the look with the costume, styling, outfits, direction, the production, like I so enjoyed it. So, you know, and I've always enjoyed fashion shows as well, because I like the thought of models and rehearsals and set and all of that. So, and so I think that I really and truly enjoyed, and whether it was Janvi or Karthik, both have called me back and said that the way, you know, you've looked at us, or that, like the eye shots of Janvi or the profile shot of Karthik, I've really, really loved it. So, and I used to think that beyond fashion shows, I won't be able to do a show. And here I am directing and putting these digital films, which I've so loved doing. So I think it's awakening something in me. So I don't know what lies in the future.
So we might see a Manish Malhotra film sometime soon.
That's right.
Well, maybe. Listen, I look forward to it, because there is one guarantee: the people are going to look gorgeous.
Thank you. Yeah, I hope so.
Right? At least there'll be the joy of that.
The heroine will wake up with lashes and perfect hair. Yeah. And chiffon sari in the snow. And exactly. The hero in the muffler and trench coat.
And why not?
Yeah.
And why not? Manish, thank you so much. It's been such a joy talking to you, and cannot wait to see what you do over the next 30 years.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Hopefully we'll be doing this again and referring to this interview.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Thank you, Manish.
Hi guys, I'm Manish Malhotra. If you liked the interview, please subscribe to Film Companion.